Before we get into the lesson, let's check out the news this week. Outside, read that for me.
Dad of New York City subway bomb plotter gets 4.5 years in prison for trying to cover up his son's plan.
Go ahead.
New York. The father of an admitted terrorist was sentenced to 4.5 years in prison Friday after he was convicted of destroying evidence and lying to investigators to cover up his son's plot to attack New York City subways in 2009 as one of a trio of suicide bombers.
Go ahead.
Muhammad Wali Zazi, 56, could have faced up to 40 years though his attorney had argued for probation because they said that he was simply trying to protect his family and had no idea what his son was up to. His son, Najibullah Zazi, has admitted that he returned from a trip to Pakistan to his family's Denver area home to practice concocting homemade bombs using chemicals extracted from common beauty supplies. He then drove to New York City in September 2009 with plans to attack the subway system in a martyrdom operation, quote unquote. Before he learned he was being watched by the FBI and fled back to Colorado. The plot was sanctioned by Al-Qaeda,
but thwarted by authorities. So now, we can end it right there. It goes on and on. One thing y'all gotta know, if the feds ever interview you, do not lie. You can get extra time for just a lie. That's the federal system. I ain't talking about local law enforcement. I ain't even talking about state. I'm talking about the feds. Once you get up to that level, if anything, and I pray ain't nobody ever have to get to that level. Doing nothing secretive up in here. We gotta put you behind up. Let's go to Habakkuk chapter 2 real quick. But brothers, just be aware, dealing with feds and on any level, I don't know what some of y'all are doing, those online, I don't know what some of y'all are doing. You lie to the feds, you're gonna get extra time just for a lie. So now, this was in 2009. The father, the father might, quote unquote, maybe he didn't know what his son was up to. But the mere fact that he destroyed evidence and tried to cover up to protect his son going to get you some time. So you parents, this is a lesson for you. You black women, Latin women, our people's good for covering up the evil in their kids' lives. You going to do some time. Just be warned. They quick to get on the news and go, oh, not my baby. Oh, Jesus. Go to jail. Habakkuk chapter 2.
Verse 7.
I want to read it. Let me hear it. That's what I want.
Shall they not rise up?
Yeah. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 7.
Habakkuk 2, verse 7.
Thought about that.
Verse 6. Shall not all these take up a parable against him? And a taunting proverb?
Wait, I'm hearing an echo here.
Reverb. Shall not all these take up a parable against him?
So the these there is meaning these nations. Some of you might think that the Bible is a fairy tale book. You might not really believe that this book is the only true book. But as we read through today's lesson, you're going to see that this is the only true book on earth. Go ahead.
Shall not all these take up a parable against him, and a taunting proverb against him, and say, woe to him that increaseth that which is not his? How long? And to him that ladeth himself with thick clay.
Notice the part where it says, woe to him that increases that which is not his. Does this country belong to the so-called white man?
No.
But he has increased it. Okay? America, the so-called white man, was the beginning of all terrorist activity when they introduced smallpox to the Native American Indians. There's a documentary on YouTube you can all look at. It's called The Canary Effect. And it goes into the history of the American Indians. To this very day, when they push the Indians on reservations, You gotta examine that word, reservation. What are they reserving them for? Okay? They put them on the worst plots of land. Okay, they didn't put them on good land, but then guess what? Under some of those plots of land throughout Texas and California, they found oil. Now guess what? We have to move them now. Wait a minute. So now when this Native American, which is the tribe of Gad out there, they're starting, they set up systems to pump the oil so that they could reap the benefits. Now it's illegal to do that. Oh, no. You're a sovereign. You're not supposed to be doing that, getting oil to take care of your people. Now it's more crimes they're putting against them. Are you for real? You kidding me? And nobody sees nothing wrong with that. Even with the Mexicans over in Arizona, the tribe of Issachar. What's that new law they got? The way they could just randomly stop a Latino, you look Mexican to me. And if you ain't got your papers, you out. And you got a lot of Negroes that laugh at that thing. You'll be surprised how quick this thing could flip on us. You Jamaicans, you Haitians, you West Indians, you're gonna laugh now, some of y'all gonna cry later. But anyway, they got where they could randomly stop them. Cause back to when we first got quote unquote emancipated, so for those of you that know a little history, remember they used to randomly stop us. Show us your papers that you free, nigga. Then Jake would take out his paper. He said, you have no papers. You're behind his back in slavery again. So we can laugh and get a good joke off Issachar because the Mexicans thought they was good and safe. You're no negro. Look what happened. The whole thing could flip. You know, the whole thing could turn around on us any moment. So, what verse you at?
Verse 6 again.
Go ahead.
Shall not all these take up a parable against him, and a taunting proverb against him, and say, woe to him that increaseth that which is not his. How long? And to him that ladeth himself with thick clay.
Go ahead, watch this.
Shall they not rise up suddenly that
this,
shall...
Stop reading fast. Shall they, the they there is who, Isaac?
The they is talking about all the other nations.
Right. The they there is the nations. Read verse 7 again.
Shall they not rise up suddenly that shall bite thee?
So God is saying prophetically that the nations shall rise up against this place and bite them. That bite them could mean a lot of, it could be like Bezalel, pull up the anonymous, there's a group, an Edomite group. And they just hacked the CIA.
Go down.
Save, see the face? That's from a movie called V for Vendetta. When it shows you that in the movie how America gets destroyed, Britain is the last country on earth, and they are very corrupt, just as America. But anyway, in that movie, they show you a lot of things. A lot of times we take things as a joke, but Esau and Hollywood, a lot of those movies they put together have symbolic meanings behind them and things that they plan to do. Yes, Leslie.
I gotta find an article. I've seen an article that 90% of all scripts that have been put out in Hollywood over the past 15 years have to pass through a council that's government funded.
Check that out.
It's a secret council. Nobody knows who they are, but some of the money that's put up for these movies is actual government money.
Right. Exactly. So a lot of times, like, we take movies as jokes, we there to get entertained. Esau is sending messages to his people. Negroes and Latinos, we're not included in a lot of these things. Some of you Hasidity blacks, because you went to Harvard. You think you in like Flynn. Negro, you not in. Go back to Habakkuk 2.
Habakkuk 2, verse 7. Shall they not rise up suddenly that shall bite thee? And awake that shall vex thee.
Now why does it say, and awake that shall vex thee? What does America have here, apart?
That's referring to the sleeper cells of the terrorists.
Exactly. All these sleeper cells. God says, shall they not awake that shall vex thee? I don't care how much you see police, ESU, and Grand Central Station. All that's a show of force A gun cannot do nothing. You even got military factions in there.
Yeah.
Grand Central. Sitting, we've always asked the question, what does a... Let me get my words right. Somebody that gets... what does a terrorist want? Does he want money?
No.
Does a terrorist want a pizza and a plane to fly somewhere?
No,
a terrorist don't want that. There are classes that tell you religious extremists, you cannot negotiate with them. I don't care how much police force there is, how much military force there is. It's die, is kill or be killed. That's it. That is it. If you see people just drop for no reason, there might be a gas explosion, you better run. Don't talk about, oh, I'm gonna get my gun ain't doing nothing. Whoa, but the military man here got all kind of weapons. He gonna die too. And the gas masks that are given only last but for so long.
Oh, yes.
We're in perilous times here, and this is just the beginning. Read that again.
Shall they not rise up suddenly that shall bite thee? And awake that shall vex thee, and thou shalt be for booties unto them.
What does the word booties translate to? Booties, booties. And it ain't talking about baby shoes. Get alive.
Treasure or...
Right. Okay. Treasure or supplies. Okay. Go ahead.
Because...
And now God's going to tell you why these nations are going to rise up against this place. Go ahead.
Because... thou hast spoiled many nations.
That's the reason why. Because thou hast spoiled many nations. Oh, some of y'all thought America was innocent. You got a lot of our people that think that this is an innocent nation. This is not an innocent nation. What's that dude, Saddam Hussein? Guess who he used to work for? CIA. What's that tall dude that just got killed?
Bin Laden.
CIA. Noriega.
CIA.
See what they did to him. And the list goes on and on. So that no one think this is a personal campaign. Read the verse again.
Because thou hast spoiled many nations, all the remnant of the people shall spoil thee.
That's the prophecy. Go ahead.
Because of men's blood.
Because of men's blood. Oh, a lot of y'all forgot about, I forgot myself, how you say it? Hiroshima and Nagasaki.
Of the land.
And for the violence of the land. Go ahead.
Of the city and of all that dwell therein.
See that? So the Bible is prophetic. You can sit in your own little corrupt mind and go, no, it can't be what this is talking about. All my life I thought that the Bible was a fairy tale book. Where is the love? Right now, somebody's saying, where's the love, brothers? This doesn't sound like love to me. Read on.
Woe to him that coveteth an evil covetousness to his house, that he may set his nest on high.
Stop. Woe, the word woe means what?
Destruction.
It says destruction to him that coveteth an evil covetousness. What does it mean to covet? Azariah. To covet.
Desire something that doesn't belong.
To desire something that does not belong to you. Now let's find out what this verse is talking about. Read it again.
Woe to him that coveteth an evil covetousness to his house.
To his house. So it's saying that this country has taken something to its house that does not belong to them. Let's see what it is. Go ahead.
That he may set his nest on high.
Wait, stop. Right there. Here's a hint. There's a clue right there. That he may set his nest on high. That he may set his nest on high. What is that talking about? It's talking about this country. What has America, Babylon the Great, taken to set their nest on high, Steve?
The moon.
The moon. And in 1969, when they landed on the moon, what was the famous slogan?
The eagle has landed.
The eagle has landed.
You're looking great. How you doing, Control?
We look good here, fine.
How about you, Telcom?
Go.
Guidance, you happy?
Go.
Fido.
Go. 2,000 feet. 2,000 feet. End of the egg. 47 degrees. Roger. 47 degrees.
Still looking very good.
Here go. Alarm. Bravo 1. Roger, 1201 alarm.
1201 alarm.
Same type, we're go, flight.
Okay, we're go.
We're go, same type, we're go.
Altitude 1600.
Eagle looking great. Roger, 1202, we copy it.
35 degrees, 750, coming down to 23. 540 feet, down at 15. 10 and 50 feet, down at 4. Altitude, velocity, light. 10 and a half down, 220 feet. 5 and 4, we're coming down nicely, 200 feet. 4 and a half down, 5 and a half down. 100 feet, 3 and a half down, 9 forward. 875 feet, guys looking good, down a half. 6 forward.
60 seconds.
Lights on, forward, forward, 40 feet down, 2.5, picking up some dust, face shadow, 4 forward, drifting to the right a little,
30 seconds,
forward, just contact light, okay, engine stop,
we copy you down, Eagle,
drifting, Tranquility Base here, the Eagle has landed.
The Eagle has landed. That's we that precept again to what?
That he may set his nest on high.
That's why it's using the word nest there. That he may set his nest on high. They just shot up a, when did they shoot that rocket up there to find water on the moon?
That was last year.
Last year, too. They've been knew there was water up there.
Yeah. Yep.
They're trying to establish things on the moon. And guess what, you blacks and Latinos, this ain't for you.
DH you off.
The lunar splash surprised everyone, including NASA scientists. They expected to find just teaspoons of water. Instead,
we found maybe about a dozen of these 2-gallon buckets worth of water.
And liftoff of
in October, NASA rocket sent a spacecraft hurtling into a crater near the moon's south pole. Special cameras recorded the mile-high plume of debris. And just this week, researchers found the chemical markers that indicate frozen water.
Now we have so much more to explore and so much more to find out.
If there is significant amounts of water, it could be broken down into elements for rocket fuel or even provide drinking water for astronauts, paving the way for a possible lunar base. But that's still well beyond the horizon.
It's one thing to know ice exists on the moon. It's another thing to be able to get it out of the ground in quantities that are usable.
Still, it's a giant leap from a supposedly dusty, dry moon Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin visited 40 years ago.
This is not your father's moon. Rather than a dead and unchanging world, it could in fact be a very dynamic and interesting one.
A moon that we may now all look at just a little differently.
There was
because a lot of blacks and Latinos are under the delusion of inclusion. Oh, I fight for Master. Master love me. Yeah, okay. All right. You're gonna be shocked and surprised. Yes, love.
Yeah, the whole thing was America trying to shoot the missile towards to see if it's defense. He already set the thing up. He shoot the missile in there to see if missile can attack what he just established in there. That's what the whole thing was about. The whole thing was not about water. He knew there was water there. He trying to shoot the missile in there to see if the missile can go through. That was the whole reason behind that.
Okay, yes.
One of the Republican candidates is talking about making the moon the 51st state.
Mm-hmm. See that?
His plan is to go up there and set up an establishment where people can live.
Mm-hmm. People. That don't, when they say people, they don't include blacks and Latinos.
There you go. That's what I was going to ask. Did that 51st state, did they have any thing on the books about blacks and Hispanics or anybody else? No. They didn't even tell us about it.
You don't need ball players and rappers up there.
Right. Exactly. What we're reading about, what we see in the news and what we're reading in the Bible proves that the Bible is a true book. But you might ask yourself, self, why is it not written plain like that? Give me Hosea 12 and 10.
Hosea 12 verse 10. I have also spoken by the prophets, and I have multiplied visions and used similitudes.
You see that? And used similitudes. Go ahead.
By the ministry of the prophets.
So when God speaks through the prophets, he uses similitudes. The New Testament used other words other than similitude. What word do we find in the New Testament? Josiah. Yahshua.
Parables.
Right, we read parables. Okay? So when the Most High speaks, he uses similitudes. He uses parables. He uses dark sayings, like it says in Psalms, the 78th chapter. From there, let's go to Isaiah 28.
Isaiah 28 verse 10. For precept must be upon precept, precept upon precept, line upon line, here a little and there a little.
So in order to understand the Bible, because the Bible is written like a puzzle. No, the Bible is not in chronological order. That's why you get some people confused in the book of Revelation. They think it's going, everything's going in order. Everything's not going in order. Neither in the book of Isaiah. Everything is not in order. It jumps around. So sure, you can read the Bible like a novel if you want to get to history, but if you want to know the mysteries of the Bible, this is, God commands us how to read it. Read it again.
For precept must be upon precept, precept upon precept, line upon line, line upon line, here a little and there a little.
So precept upon precept, line upon line, here a little in one chapter, there a little in another chapter. That's how you get the understanding of the mysteries in the Bible. That's how you understand the similitudes in the Bible, the parables in the Bible, the dark sayings in the Bible.